This recording is protected by copyright. No part may be reproduced without the prior permission of the University of South Australia.
Okay, my name's Bernard Guerin. I'm a professor of psychology at the University of South Australia. If you do psychology here, you won't probably see me till second and third year, teaching the social psychology, teaching community psychology, and then I also teach now a brand new course in language and how we use language in everyday life and why people gossip, why people chat about things, why you sit at a coffee shop and talk about for 2 hours about the Game of Thrones episode from last night. Why do people do that? Spend so much time just talking about stuff that's not even real. But you won't get me probably until second year, but they've asked me to come and tell you about the course. I'll stick mainly to the course, what you need to do to get in and what you're likely to get, and of course I will emphasise what you'll get at the University of South Australia that you won't get elsewhere, at least in South Australia, because that's what we do and what we want to emphasise mainly to you. Okay, most of you, how many of you have done psychology at secondary school, high school? Actually, quite a few now are doing that. We're actually working on a way that we might be able to get cross-credit a little bit for that. It's difficult to negotiate with the schools and all, but it's something we're hoping to do in the future at least, is be able to cross-credit if you've done year 11, 12, that you can count that towards your psychology major and have a bit of free time. For those of you who haven't done it before, psychology broadly is about people. It also includes the study of animals though, which most of the universities don't do very much. University of South Australia, that is one of our selling points, which I'll talk to you about a little bit later in the presentation. We do one of our staff members and her students and others do a lot of work with animals in the zoo, Africa and other places. So it's mainly about how to work with people, how to see people do things and be able to understand where that might be coming from. It leads to a lot of outcomes, although I do recognise many of you will have clinical psychology as your focus already and want to go into clinical programs and become a clinical psychologist, which of course you can do, although it's competitive, and I'll tell you a bit more about that as we go through the presentation. We also now have a big emphasis on cognitive neuroscience, but I'm guessing most of you will have been to the talk before this one, is that correct? Where they did a special presentation just on the cognitive neuropsych, because it's a new one for the university over the last couple of years. Okay, we have two programs. This is more the stuff you need to know. Two programs that we run. They're basically identical, but one is like a fast track. One is the normal one that most people do. So the Bachelor of Psychological Science is the one that most people do. It's easier to get into. The 3 years of psychology is identical to the 3 years of the Bachelor of Psychology. The rules of the Psychological Society of Australia, however, says that for three-year degrees, you cannot call them a Bachelor of Psychology. So we've called ours a Bachelor of Psychological Science. Every university in Australia does this. Some call it behavioural science. The term Bachelor of Psychology is reserved only for four-year programs. So, the Bachelor of Psychological Science, 3 years full-time. So you're thinking 40 hours a week, 37.5, a normal working week devoted to your psychology, unless you go part-time. You can do the fourth year. If you've got good grades across second and third year, you can then apply to go into the fourth honours year once you're in the three-year program. So you're not excluded from the fourth-year program, it's just that you're not automatically into it. Again, this is fairly standard across all of Australia. Most programs now have a three-year main degree, a special four-year program, and then people transfer from the third year over. All of this is accredited by the Australian Psych Society. Now this applies to all of the degrees in South Australia. I won't say we're better or anything in that. They're all the same. They're all accredited. What that means though, what's most important is that because it's accredited, you can do a three-year program here and then go do your fourth year honours in the University of Ballarat, the University of Melbourne, somewhere else if you wish to. You're not stuck doing it here with us the fourth year, although that'd be a great thing to do, but With the 3-year, it's accredited across Australia, so you can then do a 4th year anywhere else you wish to. Once you've done your 4-year program, it's all accredited, so you are able to go and do clinical, masters of something else, PhDs, anywhere in Australia you can apply, because it's an accredited program. They know what that means, it's regulated what goes into it. So everyone in Australia will accept your 3-year or your 4-year program to do further study. Now, we also, just to mention down the bottom there, we have a couple of double degrees. Now, what these mean, have you come across double degrees before, anyone? You basically do an extra year or an extra 2 years in some cases, but you end up with 2 degrees, 2 real degrees in different subjects. Now, we have 2 of them. One's been going about 3 or 4 years now, I think, which is a double degree with law. Now, this is a 5-year program. So law by itself is 4 years to become, do a law degree and become a lawyer. Psychology is 3 years. What you do is you combine those into a 5-year program and you come out with a 3-year accredited psychology degree and you come out with the 4-year accredited law degree. So if anyone's interested in forensic, working with courts, being a lawyer who knows a lot more about people than other lawyers might, the double degree might be something you want to look into. And the information booth has all the stuff you need to know. The law program also will tell you about their double degrees in that. The other one we have, which a lot of people choose to do, is the Bachelor of Social Science in Human Services. Now, this is really directed at people who want to, may not want to be a clinical psychologist and be all fancy and set up their little clinic, but they really want to work with people at a grassroots level. Human service organisations are everywhere. And what you can do with that one is do 4 years, just double checking, 4-year program, and you come out with your 3-year psychology degree and a 3-year social work degree. So you see what you're doing? You're combining your programs into a double degree. You do 1 year extra, but you come out with 2 recognised degrees. Now, the way we do that is simply some of the electives, you have to drop some of the electives and you really just focus on the core courses that are accredited for those mixtures of double degrees. So a lot of people don't know about that option, so you might want to investigate if that appeals to you. Doing law, psychology, coming out as a real accredited lawyer and a psychology degree, or human services with social work as well. Okay, I'll just emphasise that a bit because a lot of people have never heard of the double degrees before, but they're a nice way of adding 1 more year coming out with 2 accredited degrees. Now, that's the one that most people go in for, the 3-year program, and I'll give you the entry requirements in a minute. For those of you who do really well at high school, high TERs, you can apply to go into the 4-year program, which automatically guarantees you a place in the honours program, the 4th year, which is called an honours program. You've got to keep up a certain average. You can't like go into the 4-year, fail the first 3 years and expect to get into honours. You've got to keep up a good work. But you know, most people do that. If you get into there in the first place, you pretty much you can cope with it quite well. And that way you're guaranteed you can go into the honours program at UniSouth Australia. But you do need a higher TER to get in there. I'll show you some of the figures for that in a minute. Now, other than that, it's basically the 3 years are the same as the 3-year accredited program. It's all accredited for the honours. And then you can use the honours to go into masters of clinical with us or organisational forensic psych somewhere else, neuropsych. We may end up having a Masters of Neuropsych by the time you people have graduated through to 4th year, for example. We're playing around with some ideas at the moment. The 4th year just means you can go straight through without having to transfer at the end of your 3rd year into the 4-year program. Now again, for some people, you may do the 3 years and have decided, I don't want to do the 4th year. I don't need it. What I want to do with my life, I can do with my 3-year psychology. For that reason, you may not want to commit to the 4 years if you're not sure you actually want to carry through with it. A lot of people, though, we've found, know what they want to do. They want to do the 4 years to do a PhD or a master's, and so they want to commit to the 4 years if they've got good enough grades at their high school level. Okay, so those are the two undergraduate programs that we run. Well, actually four. If you include the double degrees, there's actually four of them. Okay, after the honours year, there's several pathways. Most people go out into the workforce at that point. With a three-year or a four-year, you can't actually call yourself a psychologist legally. You're not a clinical psychologist. At the University of South Australia, however, you will be trained in counselling, which doesn't happen elsewhere in this state. But nobody comes out of 3 or 4 years as a clinical psychologist. You have to go on and do a master's degree if you want to go that way. Some people then go on and do PhDs. PhD, you may not know about a PhD, it just means you do another 3 years of research if you want to become a researcher. That's what I always wanted to do, and that's what I do now. That's why I've never stopped doing research since I did my honours degree. Then I went and did a PhD doing research on my own topic. Then I became a lecturer, and I've done research ever since. So if you love research, you want to find stuff out, then you need an honours degree and go into a PhD. A lot of you at the moment, however, are probably thinking you want to do clinical psychology. If you do have particular questions about clinical, our head of school, Kurt Lushington, is here, and afterwards, or up in the booth, I'll tell you about, he can answer more specific questions about becoming a clinical psychologist. I'm not a clinical psych, I'm not a registered psychologist. I don't want to do that, I want to research. I want to go out and find stuff out about people and how they work. A lot of my work feeds into mental health and is about mental health, but I'm not actually, I don't need to be a clinical psychologist. And never, oh, I did when I was your age, I did want to be one, but after that I didn't, I wanted to research. So you'll learn this as you go through, and maybe you'll change your mind and find a lot of different pathways you can take. Now, if you choose to do the Masters of Clinical, again, they're a standard course across Australia, accredited. Well, our program is accredited by the Australian Psych Society and the College of Clinical Psychologists. 2 years full-time, based at the McGill campus. It's accredited. Once you've graduated, you do a lot of practical work. You take studies, you know, study abnormal psychology, assessment, and then you do a lot of practical work with actual clients all around Adelaide in different locations as your placements for that one. That takes up about 1 year out of your 2 years is all the placements you do. Graduates then, you're automatically eligible for membership of the Psych Society and the associate membership, to start with, of the College of Clinical Psychologists for that. And that's basically the legal requirement to be able to put a little plaque out saying, I'm a clinical psychologist. You need to do that. I can't do that. I've never done a clinical master's. I don't want to. So I can't put a little plaque out. Despite knowing a lot about people, I can't put a plaque out. So if you want to go that route, you need to be thinking of 3 years, a fourth year honours, and then a 2 year Masters of Clinical. If you want to do that, just keep listening, because the Psych Society has talked about changing all the structure of this. I don't know if they're going to. You know, yeah, we just don't know. The last 5 years they've been talking about making it 5 years instead of six. They talk a lot, but it'd probably be like this when you get through. You've got a long time to go if you're just starting psychology. Okay, and certainly then you'll be able to register as psychologist as well and call yourself a psychologist. Which again, legally, I've been working 30-something years and I legally cannot call myself a psychologist because I'm not registered through a master's program. I don't care, it doesn't worry me. I work with people, I research people, I deal with people, I work with mental health, research Indigenous mental health. I don't need to be doing that stuff, but for those of you who want to practice, this is the route you'll go on. Now, I'm emphasising that most of you won't come out that way, even if you want to now. It's very competitive right across Australia, not just UniSouth Australia. And many of you will decide it's not actually for you once you get in there. But for those of you who want to know, that's what you've got to do, basically. Okay, what are you going to study? 3 years, maybe 4 years? Okay, again, it's an accredited program, so you'll get all of the standard good psychology courses with theoretical work, a lot on research methodology, which is vital to be able to do psychology? How do you research people? Is a very difficult question. You know, if you want to research trees, there are standard botanical techniques. Researching people, how do you find out a people, can be very, very difficult and tricky. That's why we spend a lot of time on methodology. Applications. Now, the other thing that's special, I'll mention this again in a minute, special about the University of South Australia is we've now developed a stream of counselling and interpersonal skills that all of you doing psych with us will get across your undergraduate program. This doesn't occur at the other two universities, who shall remain nameless, in the state. And in fact, there's only about one or two others in the whole country that do this. So although you won't get into clinical psych until you decide to go on and get good grades to go on, you will be getting 3 years of training and courses on counselling, practical work, on counselling and interpersonal skills. We decided some years ago that this was just really important. Everybody coming out of psych works with people, and there was no sense in having everybody study theories and ideas about things, and then whatever job they get, suddenly they can't work with people face to face. So you'll be getting that training at the University of South Australia. Professional development, again, we consider is really important, and all of you doing the degree at University of South Australia will get a placement in normally in your third year of your degree. We'll help you set that up. So we have people we employ to help set up placements, and you do a short placement in somewhere where there are psychologists working. You can choose it yourself and find somewhere that suits your future ideas of what you want to become. Some of you may want to become educational psychologists, so you may want to do a placement working with an educational psych team at a school. Others go work in a clinic or a brain injury clinic and do a small placement there. So again, a few years ago we decided this was important for our graduates to have this practical experience. Psychology's got a long history of producing a lot of people who have never come out of their degrees but have never actually dealt with people or interacted. You're too busy studying to actually go and interact with people. So we've embedded it into our course structure for you. What you'll also get then is the 6 electives that you can specialise in, mainly third year, but some second year electives as well, where you'll get to choose things that interest you. I'll talk a bit about them a bit later on as well. So again, if you're really into language, you can do my special course, I'll advertise my course, special course on language where we talk all about how people use language. And towards the end of the course, I even teach you how to read minds. You won't get reading minds. Many of you think you'll do psychology and you'll learn to read minds. I actually have a lecture and a practical where you learn to read people's minds. It's not what you think it is. It's not spooky or anything. It's actually quite mundane, but it's about the only way you'll get to actually learn to read people's minds. And it's very difficult, but it's not spooky stuff or weird stuff like that. It's actually quite obvious. You know how some people just seem to be able to meet you and know about you and then suddenly they can guess what you're going to do? It's just telling you how to do that, which is an extension of all your other study that you will have done. So, 6 electives are some really, really interesting things. One on conservation psychology with Carla, which deals with animals and people interacting with animals at zoos, in wildlife parks. That's her research area. And so she teaches an elective on that. So if anyone's interested in animal behaviour, working as a psychology expert with zoos and others, Carla's elective is the one you want to do to follow up on that sort of work. Okay, I think I've pretty much said all of this, but let me summarise, because this is all of our selling points for our marketing part. Why go to Uni South Australia? There's Flinders, there's Adelaide, there's Interstate. We're the only ones to offer a counselling courses that you'll follow through, and the only one that gives a work placement during your third, sometimes second, but normally third year of your undergraduate. Highly experienced and recognised staff. You all recognise me after today. See, I'm a recognised staff member. We have research centres, a clinic on McGill campus, which, you know, if you're having a breakdown, you can go to the clinic. That's not what we mean by that, is that that's where you can do placements, you can do research, you can work in with the clinical staff there on campus at our own clinical clinic, psychology clinic, and that integrates them with your undergraduate and also then the clinical masters as well. And we've got some really interesting electives that you can do to take you further in a particular field that might interest you. Now, why are research so important? Some of you may not understand this yet, and I'm going to talk a bit about the research in a minute. The research is the work that we do, the people teaching you. Now, if I'd started teaching 30 years ago and I didn't do research, you know, what I know, how I teach would be so out of date that it's not funny. If you've got good researchers, that means they're keeping up to date, they're inventing new research, they're at the state of the art of carrying out research, and we then provide that to you. That's why the research at a school is so important, because that feeds back to graduate and undergraduate teaching. So you'll be getting the latest stuff that we are researching, as well as knowing what everyone around the country and everyone around the world's doing. So if you haven't sort of cottoned on to why that's important, that's the reason most, you know, schools emphasise their research standing, because that's what you get, and you don't get some, you know, five people teaching you who haven't read a book or an article in 10 years and don't really know what's going on in the labs around the world. No, we know that. We're inventing it ourselves. Carla, I mentioned already, she's, you know, one of now the top people in animal conservation psychology around the world. She goes to Rwanda and places and deals with gorillas and chimpanzees over in Africa, and she's recognised worldwide. That's what gets fed back to you. That's why the research culture is so important, even for undergraduates. Now, what do you do once you get your three-year degree or your four-year? Clinical psych, you pretty much know what you're going to be doing. What do the rest of you do, the ones who do the three-year? Well, the way I put it is that everyone who does a three-year psychology degree gets a good job. What that job actually is much more difficult to tell you. If you do physiotherapy, when you come out, you get a job as a physiotherapist. When you come out with a three-year psychology degree, people just go to a whole lot of jobs. Employers love it. They see on there that you've done psychology. And people in marketing will even say, oh, okay, let's get a psychology graduate on board. People even in architecture will say, well, let's get somebody on board who knows a bit about people and psychology. Pharmacies like people who have some psychology behind them. Now, these are the main areas, but there's a wide variety of areas of life where the employers love it if you've got psychology as your degree. You're not going to, do you see what I mean? You're not going to be getting a job where you are called a psychologist unless you do the honours and the clinical program. That's different to the physiotherapists, where you'll get a job called a physiotherapist. But there's a huge range of jobs that people get afterwards, and very, very competitive, that people want people who've got some psychology. So these are just a few of the areas where you can work. Youth workers, I mean, again, you come in there and they love it, and if you've done a placement with us, if you want to be a youth worker, do a placement where, you know, you're working with young people, then you can go to a job and say, you know, I did a research project with young people, I did a placement with young people, I've done counselling skills, 3 years of training in counselling skills, and a psychology degree. And they'll go, right, let me sign you on. You're the person we want. Now, this is supposed to work. Oh, get down there. There we go.
Australian Refugee Association, and I'm working in the Employment Services Division. I am a youth project officer, so I'm helping young refugees try and find employment, which can be pretty challenging, but when you find them work, it's really rewarding. At the moment, I'm working in Employment Services, but I would really like to get into the youth justice system at some point as well, so I mean, there's heaps of different options, and I'm still kind of figuring out which ones that I want to take. I feel passionate about this area because I've always wanted to help people, helping people in need in all the different sectors, so homelessness, youth, drug and alcohol abuse, so there's plenty to explore and plenty that I'd like to do. With University of South Australia, I had my second placement in YouthJet, which has the same board as the Australian Refugee Association. My placement with YouthJet I was working a lot more with young people from a different background. They've got funding from the Settlements Grants Program, so it's all based with young refugees. So on the placement it really helped because you could finally put all the things that you learnt in theory into practice. One of the great things about this course is even though it's not until the final year of university, you do get two placements, so you get to explore the different areas according to your placement positions. Problem-solving skills, the interviewing skills and counselling skills, things like that, it really, it finally made sense why you learnt it all and you could see the practicality of it all. So when I finished my placement at YouthJet, the Employment Services Division snuck up and offered me a job, and now I'm working for them downstairs.
Okay, so that's Amy. I remember Amy going through a few years ago. And again, like yourselves, many of you, she would not have been sitting there thinking, I must be someone working at a refugee migrant centre. That came as she went through, and as she said, she did a placement at a youth centre to start getting experience, and then it was easy. So really, any place where you're working with people, that's where a psychology degree will get you a good job in that. What does it take? Interest. You have to be interested in people. I'm assuming you all are, otherwise you wouldn't be here. If you dislike people and you never want to work with people, you probably don't want to do a psych degree. Unless you're interested in animals and you want to do animal behaviour. Critical thinking skills, but we'll help you with that as you go through. And you don't have to start off with excellent interpersonal communication skills. You'll get that in the counselling courses as you go through. Now, the tough bit, entry requirements. Don't forget, we've got two degrees. The main one most people do is the Bachelor of Psychological Science, the three-year degree. You can get in with 60. We prefer an ATAR, sorry, I was saying TER before I'm old, an ATAR of 70 will get you into that. So it's not like law or medicine or one of those. However, if you wanted to go straight into the four-year honours program with the Bachelor of Psychology, you're then looking at 96.1 for your ATAR cutoff. So fewer people get into that, and you've got to have a high high ATAR to get into that. So you see the difference? Most people, though, are quite happy to get into the psychological science, and if you really want to get into the honours, you can then transfer at the end of your third year, transfer into the fourth year anyway. The other two, the double degree, 70 and 60 again, to get into that social work, psychology, double degree, where you come out with a qualification in both of those. There are some different entry pathways, and people around the campus today can tell you more about those than I will ever know. Some people transfer from other degrees interstate sometimes if they're moved or their family's moved. If that happens to you, go see one of the experts at the uni. There's all sorts of ways you can cross-credit courses and not have to repeat something here if you've done a recognised one somewhere else. So if you are going to transfer, then go see one of the experts in the admissions section about how you can cross-credit things you've already done. The special one, 18 plus people, there is some credit. You can cross-credit for TAFE courses to some of ours. And again, go see the accreditation people in the entry admissions group and they'll be able to tell you more about that. And we also now have the Uni South Australia College, where a lot of people who are usually older people who haven't studied for a number of years go back and do like a refresher course there on how to do a university, how to be a university person, learn about essay writing again, some of those skills, and they start to mix up their coursework with their entry requirements. So they can start doing bits of psychology while they're doing the college transfer one, and then they transfer usually in their second year into the normal degree that I had on the board before. Now, there's going to be at McGill on the 18th of September. So this is from 4 o'clock in the afternoon through to 8 o'clock. There's going to be all sorts of music and food and all sorts of desirable things like that. The marketing people say work to get you there, as long as it's not pouring with rain like it is today, to get there. And you can visit the sites for that as well.